I am going to make now Rava Halwa, that is Sujjige they say. So I am going to take some medium size Rava. They also call, and this is liquid jaggery. This is not found in all places. In some of the villages where they take out the sugarcane juice to make the sugar, there in that type of mill you can get them. Only in few places. So I taken some, about 5-6 cardamom powder and little raisins, some cashew, ghee to fry that, and I kept hot water for it to be cooked in it. So let me start that. So put some ghee to this. Add some ghee and so you can also fry it with the ghee little later. First let me just put this cashews. So I am putting the already dry fry one in the pan, this suji, that is rava. Just for the better flavor of it, you can fry it for at least 1 or 1.5 minutes, you see, now because it's already been fried. So add raisins. This is very easy to make. You can also put sugar in place of this jaggery. Jaggery gives one type of taste. So now I will add this heated up water. It is slightly getting heated up. I feel this is one of the easiest sweet to be made, you know. So let it cook for a minute. This is very thick, but it tastes very good. I may put almost like two katoras of this to the halwa. In the sense, sujjige. Yeah. I put like 1.5 katora of that, I feel so. Let me put some more ghee to this. And just close and keep it for some time. This is very easy to make. It's only the mind stuff, you know, to say it. Come on, do it. We need something or the other to eat at home, time to time, so we can keep planning. So, let us close and keep it nicely, let it cook. So, grease a plate with little ghee. Of course, the halwa itself is having ghee. You can even cut and keep it, make slices after it cools. Or you can just put into the katora and eat just like that, as you wish. Now it is done. See how thick it is, and it is not sticking to the bottom of the pan. Can you see? It is not sticking. So now I am going to put it off and add this cardamom. See, when you are cooking this suji ka halwa or sajjige, how much ever ghee you put, it will just take. So, what is essential to fry that, and in between not to get stuck to the bottom, you can add little. And now, after you put off the stove, if you add 1 or 2 spoons, that will just, you know, be on the top of the halwa. It won't get absorbed much. So, it will have that shine and it will have that ghee over it floating. So now I am going to put it to the plate and make it. So it has been put off the flame before I put the ghee and the cardamom. So I'll cool it in the plate for some time. Now it is quite cool, so let me cut it. You can cut it in whichever shape you want. I am going to just cut it into square pieces, that's it. So it's come out very nice, very tasty. If you want still, you know, harder pieces, you keep it for some more time in the on the stove and just, you know, nicely stir it so that it can become much more harder pieces. I have not made them like that. I wanted it little soft, so I made it little softer type. Can you make out? Yeah. So enjoy it. Try it. Here. I have put 1 cup of suji. That is rava or semolina. And I have put about 1 and a half katoras of same measurement with that. 1 and a half katora of that jaggery syrup and few cardamom and about less than 1/2 cup of ghee. I have distributed in 3 portions of it as it was getting roasted and getting cooked and after I put off the stove. About 2 tablespoons of I have added, about 1/2 katoras. Of ghee, and this can stay at least for 2 days. It will be very good. Even you can fridge, you can keep it.